Hi, William back again, Space Mouse 1, with an update on the Nemesis model, the Scorpion. I have the second wing pod attached. There was a gap between the wing pod edge and the body of the ship. I had to use 15-minute epoxy to close up the gap. And as I used low-tack adhesive painter's tape, when I applied the epoxy, some of it ran over, but not too much. And I had to wet sand it down, then I have to touch it up again with some metallic black to get rid of that scuffed surface. And I got the resistor boards just about hooked up. I still got to install these intakes, which are goes on either side of left and right, and I got them nice and shined up with the metallic black. Another thing I want to talk about today is the keepsake ornament, which came out in the early part of 2000. I think it came out in 2003. It's a tree ornament, and it's a nice model, and I think it's pretty cool. There's a little information about it. It talks about how Commander Data and Captain Picard were abducted by Romulans, and they had to use the ship to get out of the Romulan starship of some sort. But the model is in pretty good condition. I only used it once on the tree since I've had it, and the thing is it runs off AC, which it probably has a set of rectifiers to convert the AC into DC power. But it's a nice model. It's got a lot of detail. When you light it up, it actually has two screens that light up for Picard and Mr. Data. It's a smoked canopy. Now I'm going to try to do the same thing to my model. Once I get it done, I'm going to use a smoked glass spray, a clear, like a amber. I demonstrated for you, but I don't have AC power. I'm assuming, like I said, there's a rectifier to convert the AC into a DC, so it lights up the wing pods, which light up, and the intakes, and the exhaust has a green glow, I think, to it. So, it's a good model. It's going to be the larger scale to this one, which I did recently. And when I get done, it'll be back with another update in another day or two. Have a good day. Bye for now.